2009 is ending, and this time around the end of the year, I wanted to do something special to salute 2009 as we get ready for 2010 and reminisce on all the great memories, projects, and especially members that we're fortunate to either have joined in 09, blossom in 09, or for already established members continue to kick ass in 09. So for this video, we lay tribute to the top 10 Jet Central members of 2009, whether it be a rookie or a veteran, the top people who shined in this company in 2009. And fortunately for you members, you guys don't have to compete with people like Anthony Vignoni, since he wasn't around in 09, which you should all be very thankful for since he would have killed most of you. But before we hit number 5, like the top 15 of all time countdown, you'll be treated with many top 5s. Also, keep in mind that for members that have been here for years, I will only show any and all 2009 footage they're in. I mean, after all, this is a 2009 countdown. So without further ado, let's jump off the bat with number 10. Number 10, Ernest W. Conway. Ernest has continued to be his below average self for another year in Jet Central. But then again, look what other people have been doing in the company. Nothing. Although not doing much, there's two things in particular he has accomplished this year. The first look of what the Massacre Avenue website would end up looking like, screenshots basically. And of course, a supporting role in Massacre Avenue. And you don't get much better than that, well, besides starring in it. In doing this countdown, I always have to keep in mind and being aware of people who literally did their first videos in 2009. And that left me having to decide between two people, Brandon L. Santiago and Christina M. Singh. So screw it, I decided to pick both. Coming in at number 9 is Daquan's second and third greatest recruits so far, Brandon L. Santiago and Christina M. Singh. Both has been in the recently made The Mean Computer short, made in November, and Brandon L. Santiago has also been a part of the Saw parody remake, which was made right before Christmas. I say they're at the same level right now because Brandon is in two shorts but has very small roles in them, and Christina is the star of one short, so they, you know, sort of balance out, even if Christina drinks too much Haterade. Daquan, you should be very proud, especially since your number one recruit will be coming up later in this countdown. Number 8, Amanda C. DeVille. Amanda takes a long time to do certain things, but in 2009, she finally stepped up and snagged a supporting role in Massacre Avenue. She has also taken the initiative to come up with things on her own, such as a written progress report on people, a Jet Central quiz for no recruits to see which has been paying more attention to the videos we show them, and an award show which we already have planned, and a Jet Central introductory video that talks about the company and what we are about so we have something to show new recruits. She also joined the board of directors because of her somewhat commitment, although she sort of has to learn how to pay attention better, but many others don't do much better. But it's better than nothing. So thank you, Amanda. You are proving that you at least have more potential than most girls we put faith in recently. Number 7, America Serta. Thank God almighty we are actually seeing more females in the top members countdown this time around. Unlike most people, when America joined, so far being Daquan's greatest recruit by the way, she joined with a bang. She debuted in a scene in the old attempt of Massacre Avenue, which we will no longer mention due to it pains me inside. But what got her on this list was what she did this attempt around. Not only has she offered and assisted on us using her house for this movie, but she too snagged a supporting role in Massacre Avenue. But we all know she wanted to star in the movie as Megan, thus why she offered her house in the first place. But to me, she just doesn't seem as the mega type, and that she would fit Melody better. Number 6, Aaron D. Benon. Wow, he went from number 1 of all time to number 6 of this year. What a decrease. But most probably feel he shouldn't be in it at all. Well, you gotta know something. I currently have 3 top members. My elite, you would say. 3 guys out of all my members that I don't want to lose the most. Basically my 3 veterans, Aaron, Christian, and Daquan. I believe they are like the 3 musketeers in Jet Central. Although they do sort of have a love-hate for one another. But anyways, back to Aaron. He has also been the center of many controversies throughout the year. When he left Jet Central for his break, we found out he was still wrestling with his Park Wrestling group he records in parts, when his reason for leaving was supposedly getting his life back together and focusing on school for now, so pretty much he's a liar. People also feel he doesn't deserve his tribute video, which I disagree with because it's not a tribute of how he's doing now. It's his whole career, so in some eyes, it's long overdue. So yeah, Aaron was expecting people to be sad when he left, when in reality, most just saw him as a letdown and good riddance. However, he is still a big part of this company and a legend. Plus, let's not forget, he was in the Saw parody remake used in his basement. And debate-wise, he had a debate with Christian V. Pagan, who was attacking him for being a lousy, uncommitted legend, and helped defend the legends in the anti-legend versus nearest legend alliance debate, so that counts for something. Aaron was also in the Royal Rumble 2009 earlier this year. Let's just see if him and Daquan ends up starring in Massacre Avenue 2 after all. Now it's time for the mini top 5s. First up, the top 5 disappointments of 2009. Not to be confused with the top 5 worst Jet Central members of all time. These are just people who we thought would do great and saw blossoming and becoming committed. Then sometime in 2009, completely messed it up. It's like the top 5 coulda, woulda, shoulda. But just with the people who seem to be top talent at one point or another. Star material, basically. Number 5. Number 5. Damian P. Jenkins. Wow, you just beat out Isaiah, Damian. Congratulations. Why is Damian a disappointment? Because in this whole year, we only saw him like 2 or 3 times. The only video he was really in was the Hallway Rumble 2009. And we rarely hear from him unless I go out of my way to contact him. He should take the initiative to contact us himself and tell us days he wants to come over. Waiting for us to do it just makes it seem like he doesn't really care. Like I said, we're all grown here. Speak up, show up, do something. This is why we feel he should no longer be an icon. People could barely even remember him. Number 4. Number 4, Zonique MP1. Wow, from the future potentials countdown to the disappointments countdown, says a lot about her. The bad thing about her is not only did she do the opposite of what she was supposed to do every time in the company and never listen to us, her little spoiled self thought she could just come in here and get any lead role she wants just because she can and wants to. America, you were sort of doing that too, I must admit. I don't know how worshipped or respected you are in other places, Zonique. But in Jet Central, you have to earn everything you get. It's not going to be handed to you. You have to build a career first. Unless we're desperate for a female to play a role like we are now. But other than that, she was just too young, too immature, and too jumpy. So it wouldn't have worked anyways. Number 3. Number 3. The legends. And yes, all the legends. Embarrassing, guys. You all should know better. Let's go down the list, shall we? Michael J. Costa and Eduardo S. Gomez doesn't do shit at all. I mean it, they do nothing. They are banished from even being considered Jet Central legends ever again. Michael disappeared off the face of the earth. Eduardo, still to this day, is just there. Stops by, does nothing. Anthony, the man we praise and talk so highly about, can't even call, message, anything to the people who care a lot about him that he hung out with almost all the time for a few years. Family, my ass. If I had a family of my own, I would still never forget my true friends, and I would have the decency to at least contact them every once in a while. I'm sure they have a way of communication to the outside world in the army. Jose Ajarez gassed up a lot of people with his legendary return video, which I think actually inspired America to start doing shit in Jet Central, and inspired other girls like Christina M. Singh and Fired Crystal Roman. Don't know what the big damn deal was for his video, get off his dick already. However, things he promised, like showing up, helping out, that kind of stuff, he has still failed to do, and he did that video in October. And again, let me remind you all, he lives right next to me. Right next to me. Although, I do have to admit one thing, he did a great-ass job in the anti-legends versus nearest legend alliance debate, shockingly being the MVP of his team and the most reason by far why nearest legend alliance won that debate. Persuading 6 random Jet Central members by his stretching of the truth to vote for their team, and none, I repeat, none, voting for the anti-legends. Damn, that's power. And Aaron canceled a movie, then really didn't accomplish anything at all. Soul parody, debates, big whoop. Way to go above and beyond, guys, and prove you deserve to be legends, not. Number two, Brian Y. Sosa. Wow, no matter what, we still seem to always mention this guy in something somehow. What can we say that hasn't already been said? Had a decent career, general manager, Fresh Blood 3, video blogs, all that. All before 2009, by the way. And was going to star in Massacre Avenue, the 5th attempt. But he proved to everyone he's just a loudmouth, trash-talking, all bark but no bite, cowardly punk that never really deserved to be here in the first place. However, surprisingly, at one point, he really did commit to Jet Central, more than most people have. Talking about JC's future and all that, and showing up almost as much as we needed him. We definitely had to fire him once he started hitting on Amanda, realizing that he did the same thing with Kayla years ago, in which he said he won't try to hit on anyone anymore. What a filthy lie this guy is. Also revealing the fact that he would hit on any girl that joins the company, which is definitely a no-no. He even would have tried to hit on the at-the-time 14-year-old Zonique if I didn't stop them from meeting. Now that's just child molesting, nasty. So son, no girl that joins would ever agree to go out with you anyway, so why lose the company in trying? A lot to lose and nothing to gain.
Number 1.
And the number 1 biggest disappointment of 2009 is... Kayla S. Moya. Oh boy, what you have become, Kayla. What you have become. Let's start from the beginning, shall we? I started over Massacre Avenue after the 5th attempt due to too many main characters and the lovely commitment from these two. And called Kayla, telling her I wanted her and Christian to start in this version that we are doing now. She said, woohoo, I'm so excited. I continued to talk to her throughout the weeks up until the first pre-production meeting, and she continued to say how excited she was. Then when it was time for the meeting and ultimately to start the movie, she apparently forgot our numbers, who we are, our AIM screen names, etc. Leading us to this day, months later, to still try to scout around and send people to recruit to try to find someone else to play Megan, the main character which Kayla named it was based around, by the way. Apparently she was in the hospital for a little while, but that was a bunch of months ago. From what I hear, she walks around, uploads stupid pictures on MySpace, and is perfectly fine. The least this girl could have done was be a grown woman and just call or text to tell us she can't do it, but she didn't even have the decency to do that. She has proven that she is unreliable, unfaithful, and fake. Plastic fake. More fake than Brian Sosa. Yup, I went there. At least he didn't disappear when we started a movie that he was not forced to do, but agreed to do. Kayla, you bring great dishonor to the greatest female title, and I pray, pray we can find a much more worthy and reliable girl to take that spot from you as soon as possible. Now it's time for the top 5 moments of 2009. These are the biggest stories in Jet Central of 2009, situations and events that made an impact this year. Things that weren't really revolutionary, but kind of gathered up a buzz in JC.
Number 5.
Number 5. Kimberly and Crystal gets fired. The reason this is on the list is that both got fired within a few months and both were supposed to be in Massacre Avenue. Kimberly actually first was supposed to be Megan, our Kayla replacement, and we had very high hopes for her. Then she basically proved to us that she doesn't really care about the company and things about it. So then we just made a Raven, a supporting character. Then it went even further and she proved that she was just another one-time shower and went down a row of uncommitment until she did completely horrible and we had no choice but to fire her. Crystal is less important. Recruited in by Aaron, by the way. She was the original Melody and we removed her because all she did was talk smack about her projects and did not have the qualities of a team player whatsoever. I love how she said she was the most professional when she was doing the Soldier Boy on set and staring as well as smiling at the camera during one of my shots, making it unusable. Thanks, girls, for being a waste of time this year.
Number 4.
Number 4. Two well-known members return, or do they? This is talking about Jose and Santos' supposed great returns. While they said a lot of good things to hype people up, especially Jose, do you see them in any parodies? No? Shorts? Massacre Avenue? Anything? Do you even see them at my house? I stand corrected.
Number 3.
Number 3. Massacre Avenue gets cancelled again. One bad story was the fact that the 5th attempt of Massacre Avenue got cancelled, mostly because of Daquan and Aaron's lack of commitment, but also because there was too many main characters, and I hated to death the loser whose house we were using at the time. It hurt everyone that really put their heart and soul into finishing the movie, and it was actually almost halfway done. What a freaking killjoy. I know myself, Alonzo, Lazarus, Christian, and Brian Harris were the most disappointed in the cancellation of this movie. But hey, now that I look back on it, it was probably for the better anyways.
Number 2.
Number 2, Daquan calls out the Legends. The definite biggest rivalry of the year is Daquan's rivalry against the Legends, which kind of really started out as Daquan against Aaron as a Legend. But once Jose supposedly returned, that's when Daquan had it up to here with Legends in general, and that they shouldn't be Legends anymore. Christian and Ralph joined Daquan in that quest to rid Jet Central of supposed unworthy and overall not doing shit Legends. Then Brian A. Neris came to aid and help out the Legends and defend them. Thus, it soon became sort of a Daquan versus Brian A. Neris rivalry after that, with Daquan saying Neris doesn't deserve vice president and to be an icon now, and Neris saying that Daquan is just a dictator that just wants to cause problems and make drama, like Brian Sosa. Oh, yup, he went there.
Number 1.
And the number one moment of 2009 is Massacre Avenue starts up again. Yup, our current and last attempt of Massacre Avenue starting up is the number one moment of 2009. More than half of our top 10 greatest of 2009 contenders are in Massacre Avenue, and this is definitely going to be the biggest project we have made since our startup of Jazz Central 2001. It stars me, Christian, and whoever gets the female lead, and it should be finished before mid-2010, so be on the lookout for that next year. Last but not least, we got to name the top 5 videos we did this year. Massacre Avenue won't be on this list due to the fact that it won't be finished until 2010. Okay, let's get started.
Number 5.
Number 5, Hallway Rumble 2009. Our first, last, and only match we did in 2009. Wow, we went a whole year without really wrestling. We did this match right after premiering the top 15 Jazz Central members of all time countdown to most of our members, and it turned out to be a good match. 8 guys in a Royal Rumble type of match, eliminations through the door. This was Raphael's first video on Jazz Central and had many great competitors such as Aaron Benam, Brian Naris, and Damian Jenkins, who basically returned to Jazz Central to do that one match. That was also Kayla's last appearance in a video, being the host, which is not saying much because the only other project she was in was Fresh Blood 3. Brian A. Naris ended up winning the whole thing. Congrats, Naris.
Number 4.
Number 4, Jet Reviews, Pac-Man 2, The New Adventures. So far, the only game review I have done, for now. In this game review, I reviewed a game that used to stress and piss me off so much when I was little, Pac-Man 2, The New Adventures. Watch the video to see what I'm talking about. I personally like this because it was new and different, and I think I did a great job on the editing and gathering all the clips of the game together for this. Now I kind of know more about how James Waffle feels when making these. And also, let's not forget, some hilarious acting by Raphael. I can't even explain what he does in this video, you're just going to have to see it for yourself.
Number 3.
Number 3, Jet Short Films, The Paranormal Activity Parody. What really made this parody special? The mocking of a very overrated B-movie? The comedic comedy references to it? Seeing Naris take a piss? No. It was Joey, of course. Now, I'm not really talking for myself, but many people agree that Joey was their favorite part of the video because he's just so gangsta and angry and comedic and jokes around in some of the most messed up ways. So he's very entertaining and people gain an attraction to him. But this isn't about Joey, it's also about Daquan, Raphael, and Ayers, who did pretty good as well. And the night parts were definitely a classic.
Number 2.
Number 2, Jet Short Films, The Mean Computer. Not to be confused with the parody, The Mean Computer had its own original comedy. It had first appearance in a Jazz Central video, Christina M. Singh, which is arguing with a computer that is basically cursing and insulting her for the years of her potty mouth, the introduction of our new Jazz Central catchphrase, Touch My Spacebar, and actually had a lot of us in it, including Christian V. Pagan at the end, and Brandon L. Santiago, in which it was his first video as well. It also got more popular than most of our videos on YouTube, which I think is because that a lot of people who knew Singh watched it and she told them to. It's just really funny. Check it out whenever you want.
Number 1.
And the number 1 project of 2009 is... Jet Short Film, Saw Parody Remake. Our last Jet Short Film of the year, the Saw Parody had almost everybody in Jazz Central, and introduced America Serta and Quaya Brazil in their first video. Aside from them two, this video had a big cast. This video had heavy hitters like Daquan, Aaron, and me, rookies like Raphael and Dioris, outsider Brandon, and our former vice president Brian A. Naris, which by the way, he is actually the first one ever in Jazz Central history, so that's pretty historic. It also had a lot of Saw references, of course, loaded with a lot of funny moments and random things. So yeah, if you like the Saw movies, you probably will like this parody, which as a matter of fact is a remake of an old parody I made a few years back with Santos, Brian Sosa, Matthew, and legend Anthony Vignoni and alumni legend Michael J. Acosta. I even used some of the same lines and jokes from the original version in the new version with different people, of course. Not to mention the old version was filmed at the now-fired Brian Sosa's basement a few years back when everyone besides Daquan and Aaron wasn't even around in Jet Central. The reason we had to remake it was because 1. The old attempt of making it was never finished, and 2. The tape which it was on fucked up and messed up the audio and visual for like the first 5 minutes. I wanted samples for this one so I can have at least one person come back for the remake, but oh well, we can dream, can't we? We did a lot of projects this year, but these 5 seem to be the best. There's 2 things I noticed most about all these videos though. The first thing was that from the number 5 video to the number 1 video, the videos were actually created in that order this year. Goes to show we kept improving in videos as the months went on. And the second thing, the only person that was in all five videos was Rafael A. Llanos. And now, back to the countdown, I give you the top five Jet Central members of 2009. Number 5, Brian A. Naris. Brian A. Naris has did a steadily okay job this year. I still believe 08 was his best year yet, but there's a reason he went from number 7 to number 5. Brian A. Naris has a landslide of a win against Daquan's team. He has been in the Paranormal Activity parody, the Saw parody remake, and, of course, has a supporting role in Massacre Avenue. But other than that, we don't really see him, and let's not forget, he tried to quit the company on many occasions and usually always has something dramatically depressing to say, which brought him down a notch or two. In other words, he'd rather say bye than see you later. Because of that, we can never be safe with him, because it's unpredictable what he's going to say next to make us wonder about him. Although I don't take it personally, it's still something we have to be alert about. But he still somewhat kicks ass, and that's what we respect about him. Also, earlier this year was the Hallway Rumble 2009, which Brian A. Naris won. And becoming an icon this year was also a big accomplishment. Number 4, Daquan M. Alexander. Bumped up two spots from the top 15, Daquan has also been the center of controversy, but in his case, he's the one that actually starts it. It was his idea to make a group to remove all the legends from Jet Central, thinking they don't do anything anymore and no longer deserve to be called legends. Thus why him, Icon Christian, and Rookie Ralph formed the Anti-Legends team and went against legends Aaron and Jose, as well as Brian Naris, who was there to defend the legacy of the legends. Even though the legends pretty much won that debate with 6 votes from other members to 0 for Daquan's group, that only fueled Daquan's motives and ego. But don't get him confused with Brian Sosa, who just did shit to cause problems and to be an attention whore. Daquan does things because he does what he strongly believes in. If he has a problem with something in the company, he doesn't just deal with it. He speaks his mind and does whatever he has to do to make changes and have shit happen. He always tries to make the company better and quote unquote less biased. And with everything he does, that shows he is strong and does have the quality of a strong leader. Not to mention, he is one of my top 3 overall members in general so far. Also, he was in the Paranormal Activity parody we did on Halloween, the Mean Computer short, and the Saw parody remake, so he's been in his fair share of projects too. Then, which also got him to the spot, is his amazing recruiting record. I think I can safely say he is the greatest recruiter so far, recruiting 5 people into Jet Central, in which 4 of them were actually girls. And unlike Ralph's poor excuse for recruits, no offense Ralph, each of them showed up multiple times and actually did stuff, whether it's being in Massacre Avenue, a short, or random videos. So Daquan, congrats, and hopefully you finally get to star in a movie, like possibly part 2, and officially have accomplished just about everything in Jet Central. Well, that and CEO, legend, etc. I say hopefully because Daquan is almost as unpredictable as Naris, but at least he never said he would leave JC, although he hopes to finally leave Rising Star already. But believe I've been about mine. I shine when it's time to shine. Number 3, Christian V. Pagan. Starring in Massacre Avenue, enough said. Probably the highest position in the company is owned by this guy, Christian V. Pagan. Still an icon in Jet Central, Christian V. Pagan has gone through another year of somewhat committing in Jet Central. You can also see him in a little hilarious part in the Mean Computer parody, as well as a debate against Aaron, where he blabbed and blabbed and blabbed his ass off about Aaron losing his passion and all that. He was also in the Anti-Legends vs. Naris Legends Alliance debate. There's not much else to say. In 2010, when the movie is finally done, that will probably definitely be the era of Christian V. Pagan and whoever gets the Megan role. As long as he stays strong with the company and keeps doing what he has to do in JC, I can definitely see him as one of the best. Even though he sort of is already, being that he's in my little 3 Musketeers thing. And to Jose calling him a bad actor, you must be fucking crazy or drunk on some shit to say that. I think you're confusing him with Kumar. Christian is an excellent actor and a great member.
And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going to the beat. And everything is going.
Number 2, Dioris M. Paredes. Wow, that guy we got from the Park Wrestling thing is actually number 2. More importantly, a rookie is number two. It goes to show that your rank doesn't really have anything to do with how committed and dedicated you can and should be. Diaris started his career in April of 2009, being in the cross interview video with Joey, as they interview each other. Then he quickly went on to get a supporting role in Massacre Avenue, as well as hosting with me a progress report on the first day of shooting Massacre Avenue, and the results of the Who Should Be the Third Main Character poll. He also went on to become a board of director, in which the only other one is Amanda C. Davila. Basically, he was part of that elite group that now discusses things like new recruits, firings, new projects, and everything else basically. He also became my editing assistant for editing Massacre Avenue on the computer. And without me saying anything, he started to do his own videos in his own house, updating Just Censor members on things from members to films. He was also in the Mean Computer short and Saw parody remake, as well as hosted the Anti-Legends vs. Nearest Legends Alliance debate. The Diaris proves that he is one of the most committed and involved rookies in Just Censor history, if not the most. However, there was only one person that was able to do just a little bit better.
Escobar season has returned.
It's been a long time. Been a long time coming. It's life or death for me, man. But you know, there's no turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am.
Feel me?
Let's go. You can hate me now.
QB.
But I won't stop now.
Real niggas,
cause I can't stop now.
Brave hearts,
you can hate me now.
Come on,
but
you
I won't
hate
stop
me,
now.
You too.
Cause I can't stop now.
Yo, what up, niggas and bitches? Joey over here, son. Yeah, rocking the NYC. You know how I do, baby. BX all day, every day. And you know what? I'm fucking shocked, yo. I don't know what to say, son. I'm speechless, son. Fucking all boggled in my mind. Can't believe my little punk ass brother finally gave me the recognition I deserve. Finally gave me the praise I deserve. For everything I do. For all the realness, son. I keep that shit real, son. I'm the realest motherfucker in this company. But you know what? I would say I'm honored. I would say, you know, I'm grateful. But you know what? Fuck that shit. I deserve it, son. Honor my fucking dick, man. Yeah, so you know your boy Joey, number one on the countdown. You seen what I did this year? I did that hilarious ass, you know, Paranormal Activity parody. Yo, that shit was hot. Why was it hot? Cause I was in it, homie. Fuck all the rest of those niggas, son. I was in it. That shit made that shit hot. And just for y'all people that wanna know, that was acting. I wasn't really scared, alright? That was acting, my niggas. That's what we do here. And you know what? I also made an appearance in Jose's little fucking video too. But you know what? I get to poppin'. I'm a G, and this is how I do. So you know what? Again, thanks to Jet Central, thanks to all the motherfucking people in it, Brian Neris, Christian Pagan, Daquan, Aaron, all the other fucking non-important people. Oh yeah, and thanks to Christina Singh for being a hater, because you know, you make me more popular, you know? Bitches like you make me more popular. So you know what? Just be a whore somewhere else, you know? Because I don't need your shit. Because you know what? No one's going to mess up my mood. No one's going to stop my fire. No one's going to stop my flow. Haha, Joey. Paranormal Activity, that fucking cross interview son with Diaris, that nigga ain't as cool as me. Fucking that shit with Jose, man, I kick ass on 09, son. And you know what? In 2010, get ready, niggas. Get ready, because Joey's gonna be even more ruthless. Joey's gonna be even more gangster. Joey's gonna be even more hard. Yeah, Joey, bitch. Yeah son. Reason, but you're not number one on the countdown. What? Yeah, you're actually not in the countdown at all. The number one spot is for someone else.
Ain't that a bitch?
When doing the top 5 biggest future potentials in the top 15 countdown, I was unfortunate to realize my predictions were way off. Angel and Zonique turned out to be failures and would not even make it to 2009, let alone the future of Jet Central. Christina M. Singh should have been like number 3 while Amanda gets number 2. This is without the Auras, Brandon, and America technically counting yet. And the guy who should have been number 1 was Rafael A. Llanos, who actually came at number 4. Well, now he is finally going to get the spot he deserves. At number 1 is Rafael A. Llanos. Just like the Auras, his career technically started and blossomed in 09. Basically, him and the Auras destroyed in 09 and pretty much made that year their own. Rafael actually started his career near the beginning of 2009, taking part in the Hallway Rumble 2009, perfectly named. He has also been in the Jet Reviews, Pac-Man 2 The New Adventures review that I did around July, my first game review, and last so far. Also, just like Daquan, has been a part of the 3 shorts made this year, the Paranormal Activity parody, Mean Computer short, and Saw parody remake. And now he has a supporting role in Massacre Avenue. He was also in Daquan's Anti-Legends team against Nerissa's Legend Alliance. But the type of career path he is following is different from most. He is trying to become a successful recruiter, which is a great path to go on because a recruiter can pretty much decide who's the next great members of Just Central and possibly the next movie stars of her features. But I'm sure Daquan knows all about that. However, although not Raphael's fault, and unlike Daquan's recruits, Raphael's recruits doesn't even have the decency to at least show up once and at least give the company a try. But that doesn't reflect Raphael's recruiting abilities, it just reflects the type of girls he tries to bring in. I'll say it before and I'll say it again. These girls have time to hang out with significant others or friends and do fun stuff, but they can't come even for a little while to see everything we offer. Oh well, I guess they're just not worth our time, which is why I made fun of them in this cartoon about them. How true this cartoon is. Anyways, thank you, Rafael, on your commitment and everything you sacrificed and contributed to this company, as well as everyone else in this countdown. You know, it's nice to see some of the new generation of members in the top slots, or even in this countdown period. I have faith in all the potential newbies trying to make a name for themselves and prove they want to have a bright career. As 2009 ends, so does another great Jet Central year full of many memories, projects, and members as we go into 2010 and get ready for another great year of memories, projects, and members. I would just like to thank everyone that was a part of this countdown, showing they have enough potential and passion to shine in this business. And I would also like to thank everyone who watched this. But more importantly, in advance, I would like to thank the members that will make 2010 special and kick ass in 2010. Whether it's one or more of you that are here today, and or possibly new recruits that will become members in 2010 and become the next wave of future potentials. Anyways, take care everybody, and let's rock in 2010. What's up everybody? You guys just seen the top 10 members of 2009, or more importantly, these guys, the guys that are in the Jet Central top 10 members of 2009, all of these guys, especially Rafael. I know he was freaking out when that little joke was with Joey being number one. We just want to take this time to, you know, have you go around what people think about the video and each other and blah blah blah. So I guess you start with Daquan.
Alright, so first and foremost, my bad. I want to thank my recruits. Cause they were in that motherfucker. I got one behind me. Show yourself, one behind the camera.
Ah! Oh yeah. You see yourself? Wait. No, that's not to you. There you go.
I got one that's, you know, a hater apparently, but, you know, at least she was doing her shit.
Yeah.
And the other one was in the movie and only have like, what? One failure?
Who?
So, Zonique.
Oh yeah.
Other than that, I think you motherfuckers did great. We're gonna take over the countdown next year.
Ooh.
Like 2, 3, and 4.
At least.
I'm happy for Ross being number one.
The man. He's the man today.
This is
Rafael Day right
the
now.
The two rookies.
Thank you.
The two rookies. No, collided. This motherfucker was on my team trying to get rid of the legend.
Number two and number one.
Step on, man.
Number two and number one.
All right, so I'm done. Anybody else?
America, why don't you go now?
Joy should have been in this motherfucking countdown, first of all.
Okay?
Look at Ross's face.
You're gonna still
Well, I guess you technically was, but wasn't, pretty much. So I guess you got what you wanted.
And I'm happy for me and everybody here.
Yeah.
We're gonna leave number one for last, so we're gonna go to Amanda right now.
What am I gonna say besides the fact that I'm happy with everybody's progress? Especially you, you're like my hero right now.
You gotta be happy about your...
Because you came out of like nowhere and you just blew us away. So, you know, you definitely deserve
but,
it. And Raphael,
she is not that
foremost, alright? Raphael, me and him, we talk online and stuff about recruits and he does this thing, so
yeah.
I think he deserves it. So, you know, give him a round of applause.
He's a good people to look up to.
Alright,
well, now
we have to look up.
Let's get to number one of last year. Well, not last year though, of all time shit. Aaron Benam.
Well, I want to say I'm really happy that finally this countdown actually has a lot of new generations, which is something I have to say I've been looking forward to for a long time. And I can't say, you know, the spot that I had was the spot that I earned, you know. I'm not asking for number one or nothing like that. I'm proud that these guys earned it, especially Ralph over here. Mm-hmm. Because in all honesty, nobody thought he would do it, but he proved everybody wrong.
Well, so I give you respect.
Okay.
You know you guys thought Joey got number one.
And I already know for a fact, I'm going to have the fact that I do regret canceling the first Massacre Avenue. Daquan, you're in it with me.
Thank you. At least apologize for it. It was horrible.
I'll have it on my conscience for a long time, right. But...
We're taking over number two.
Yeah, maybe you can redeem themselves.
Right?
They can redeem themselves.
1 to 2.
We're going to be number two, but you know what? We're still going to make that movie even more epic as always. But my main announcement is 2010 is going to be a big surprise because now that the new generation is stepping up, I have to say I'm looking forward to it because around mid-2010, I'm going to return. And I'm gonna make it a very great
game. The rookie's on the majority right now.
He finally got his wish.
The rookie got the majority.
Go against new people.
Yeah.
Give him a round of applause.
I want the new generations to give me a good challenge, and I'm
that's what I like. Not just newbies stepping up, legends stepping up, everyone stepping up. Rising star.
Stationary star.
Going to Icon.
Whatever.
look, she said you're going to Icon.
New CEO. Icon. Yeah, new Icon. CEO, give it time. CEO, give it time.
All right, people. Now let's get to our number two in the countdown, Dior Sempere.
Yeah!
Just looking at what I saw, I was almost getting ready to cry right now. I flipped out. Ralph, you beat me to the punch. Now you're in my total.
I know Ralph almost cried when he saw Joey.
You know you want, man. Out of everything that I've done in this company, I'd like to say thank all of you guys for showing me a lot of respect, support, and love throughout good times and bad times. All the shit that I've been going through, and you know. Joe, thank you for making me board of director, and thank you for actually giving me the chance to be part of this movie and being your assistant editor.
Yeah, man.
I love all you guys right now. Like, seriously.
I love you too.
You guys gave me a shot. You guys gave me the chance to do something that I've never even done before, and I'm accomplishing it right now. Being in number two, beating him.
You know what? It's okay.
Dior is owned.
Well,
out of everything that I've done, you guys right now are my family. I love all you guys and I respect y'all. Thank you for putting me where I needed to be.
Awesome. You're welcome, bro. Glad to have you on board. And now, let's get to our number three spots. Our icon and main character of Massacre Avenue, Christian V.
Well, actually, what I was going to say is, well, thank you always, guys at Jet Central, for tolerating me, especially tolerating my mouth, because I know that I can run all day, every day.
Yes, sir.
We know.
But, you know, Jet Central, to me, has always been a very supportive place, a very creative place. And with the new generation coming on the scene, it has been a very interesting ride. Like I said, like these two guys already, you got Dior, you got Raphael, man, they coming out of the gate.
We fucking sold it. It's all about you two.
You got Daquan coming right out of the gate, causing controversy, getting people to pay attention. We need people like that in the company. We need Kitty to do stuff like that. And we need every generation. But of course, main man Joe, man, seen him since the beginning, since he first started this thing, man. And it's been an incredible ride, so I'm very honored that you even put me on that list. As always, I'm always humbled to be a part of Jet Central, and I hope to make it something someday.
Yeah, man. And you know what's funny? We have two girls in the room this time, as opposed to last time we had Kayla.
Woo!
And Kayla. So, yeah, we have women.
That's two steps up.
We have, two worthy
women. Yo, wait a minute now. She's taking Kayla's position. She is. She's taking Kayla's position.
All right,
let's get to Nerys.
So now we get to
Brian A. Naris, he has an announcement and he wants to say what he thinks, so hit it.
Out of Four quick announcements. One, a happy, we helped make Aaron's wish come true, which is to give a new breed. And also,
right.
Yep, and also, I'm happy I contributed that with this wonderful guy right here. Look at this guy. Ralph, man.
That's his recruit, too, for my anyone recruit. That knows. Ralph is his recruit. My and look at where
he's
got.
This is the one that recruited me also in this company. Yep. So I have to thank him for that, too.
And another thing, if there's anything, we all know we have to give credit when credit is due. I give IKW this one credit. We got one of their best men right there. Yeah.
They're very best.
Wait.
Sorry, Bobby Aaron. Yo, they're very best.
No. Fuck IKW. We took your best.
Yup. We took your people.
Fuck IKW.
I challenge you to a match, homie.
Yeah. Like your people made them better.
Because really,
I hope they watch this. I hope they watch this.
Because really, without Aaron and Dioris, they're just a bunch of men wrestling in the park.
Pretty much.
Yes, true. Yes.
They're the only talent that those guys have. And now, the number one spot on the countdown.
Raphael!
And you know what's funny? He was behind the camera the first time and he was pretty much a nobody, you would say. And look at where he's gone in like a year. So go ahead.
He grew so much.
Well, I just want to say thanks, Joe, for the opportunity, man.
No problem, bro.
Been great. Thanks, everybody, for supporting me, helping me out, making sure that I've been doing my shit.
Love you more.
Love you too.
You like Obama right now?
Thank you.
And I'm glad that my work is finally being shown somewhere. This is not gonna stop 2010. Gonna keep it going.
Yeah, man.
And I'm glad to show my man Dioris some respect here because he came in number two. Yep. We stole definitely some competition.
They killed 2009.
We got it.
They killed 2009. They killed
2009.
Yep. Oh, 2009 was our year. We took it.
Now it's time for 2010.
And for 2010, one word: consistency. We're gonna keep it coming. Woo! That's it.
Woo!
Jet Central! Two last announcements. One, Damon P. Jenkins, I'm sorry, but the majority
Make
rule,
it official.
I am denouncing you from your icon role.
Damien, you are no longer an icon. Sorry, bro, you're never here.
Yeah, and second, regarding Daquan and Christian, I talked a lot with Joe. Keep at more parodies. You'll be at icon sooner than you think. And because you have your ears here, start doing parodies and do this movie. It's not too far from you keeping legend status. Mm-hmm. And four.
Second Hall of Famer, you're saying.
Yeah, ooh, my last award.
Kind of make it third.
No.
As your ex-VP, I am denouncing my role. It's not the work. I can do the work, but it belongs to somebody who needs to, who's here on a daily basis. You know, has the passion, but even, you know, wants to come here. And I know when to give up something such as delicate as this. I'm giving up my VP role. I'll stick to Icon. Because I know there's more and more people than that deserve it.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, well, man. That's about it. We'd like to thank you all for watching. And definitely, 2010 will kick ass. We'll see most of these guys here again. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be hot. So,
JC forever.
JC.
Porn and goodies.
Yeah. That too. Peace, people.
We out.
Now let's get drunk and play ping pong.
It's funny because I'm the nobody.
Well, Ralph was in your situation last year, so let's see.
Yeah. Beer pong.